Hi, welcome back to Maker Mindset. This is the third part in a series that is going over the process of building the Ender 3 Pro 3D printer. If you never built a printer before, or if you recently built your printer and you are having problems with it, then this video series is for you. So let's continue. We'll begin this part of the series with step 3, which is attaching the monitor and the power supply. As you can see on the 3D animation, the installation of the monitor and the power supply are pretty simple, so we are going to go over them very quickly. Actually, we'll start with the power supply. Now, if you live in a country where the voltage on your wall socket is 220 volts, then you should skip this. However, if you live in a country where the voltage is around 115 volts, then you must take this step in order for a printer to work properly. To install the power supply, we are going to need the M420 screws, and we are going to need the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. Now, you prop up the power supply against the 2040 aluminum extrusion from the left-hand side of the printer and screw away. At this point, you shouldn't be too concerned about tightening the screws too much and destroying the threads, because you are tightening steel screws against steel threads. But don't go crazy here. Just tighten the screws well enough so that the power supply is not going to just fall off. Now it's time to install the monitor. We just place it here in front of the left foot of the printer, and we'll need to pick up the M58 screws. And for this, you need again the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. There's nothing special about mounting the monitor. But again, you will have to remember that you will be screwing steel screws into aluminum threads. You tighten the screws just well enough so the monitor will stay firm, but don't go crazy tight because you run the risk of destroying the aluminum threads. That's it. Now it's time to attach the Z-stop switch. This step is going to be very short. We just need to screw this little sensor to the 2040 aluminum extrusion of the right-hand side. The ZX switch should be in the same bag as the filament sample that comes with the printer. Here it is. And for this task, you will need the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. First, you need to loosen those screws so that the T-nuts will be able to go deep enough inside of the gap and turn sideways. This little plastic notch is going to be at the top of the right foot of the printer. The T-nuts should not give you any headache turning sideways, because you are attaching them to a vertical aluminum extrusion. Done! Now, on step 5, we're going to attach the Z-axis stepper motor. As you can see on the 3D animation, we will not accomplish much at the current step. We'll just attach the stepper motor to the aluminum extrusion with two screws. And for this task, we'll need two M4 18P screws. and we'll also need the mid-size hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. Here is the Z-axis stepper motor, which comes with this plastic bracket. You should screw this stepper motor right behind the 2040 aluminum extrusion where you attached the Z-stop switch. At this point, you don't need to tighten the screws much. In fact, we're going to revisit the installation of this part in a future step. This step is done. On step 6, we will need to roll in the hotend carriage and attach the Z-axis passive block to the gantry. As opposed to the previous step, this one is a little more involving because it will require the passive block to be perfectly aligned with the 2040 aluminum extrusion. The first thing to do is to carefully pick up the hot end carriage, making sure that you don't touch the print nozzle because the acids on your fingers may encourage oxidation. For this, the wheel that has the eccentric nut will stay at the bottom, and the part where the electric cable mesh and the bolting tube are coming out of are going to be pointing upwards. Now you pick up the partially assembled gantry with the QR code facing you, and roll in the hot end carriage into the 2020 aluminum extrusion. Now pick up the passive block and turn it this way, where the head of this screw will be inside of this recess found here on the 2020 aluminum extrusion. For this task, we'll need to pick up two M4 16 screws, and you will need the mid-size hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. And here comes yet another very important little trick. We'll start by putting the screws on, but not tightening any of them yet. Now, you actually need to tighten this screw very well, and you're not supposed to tighten this other one. Leave it pretty loose. As you can see, the passive block can move up and down, but it offers some resistance. Here you're supposed to roll in the gantry from the top. I placed a clamp on the printer's right side 2040 aluminum extrusion to stop the gantry from rolling all the way to the bottom. With the gantry rolled into place, the Z-axis passive block will be perfectly aligned with the 2040 aluminum extrusion. So now you can fully tighten both screws with the knowledge that the passive block is properly aligned. This step is over. On step 7, we just need to attach the belt tensioner to the gantry. Since we don't have the belt attached yet, attaching the belt tensioner is going to be very simple. Here is the belt tensioner. And for this task, you need to get the second largest hex wrench from the ones that came with the printer. What we need to do here is to loosen the T-nuts enough so that they will be able to enter into the groove on the side of the aluminum extrusion and turn sideways. At the moment, there is no point in tightening the screws too much. After all, the belt is not even connected yet. So, here it is. That's it for now. This video is over, but there will be more next week. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching this video all the way to the end. If you want to watch the rest of this series, you can click on this link here on the top, and at the bottom you have a link to a video that the YouTube algorithm thinks will be the best fit for you. So, we'll see you next time.